Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, I explained about the lawmaking process, which is followed by Indian Parliament. And in today's lecture, I will explain about the procedure by which Parliament controls the executive. How does the Parliament control the executive? The Parliament controls the purse strings of the executive to ensure that the government would be sensitive to public expectations and responsible and accountable to their needs and aspirations. It is important that body elected by the people, that is the legislature, controls it. If the Parliament is active and vigilant, can we keep regular and effective check on the executive? There are many ways in which the Parliament can control the executive, but basic of them all is the power and freedom of the legislators as people's representative to work effectively and fearlessly. And now the instruments or methods by which Parliament can control. First, deliberation and discussion. Second, approval and refusal of laws. Third, financial control. Fourth, no confidence motion. And now we will study about all these in the detail one by one. In the first instrument or method, deliberation and discussion. In this category, we consider three main categories. They are question hour, zero hour, and adjournment motion. These are the three different ways in which opposition or any other member of the house can ask the question to the ruling party or executive, that is Council of Ministers. Firstly, the question hour. The question hour, which is held every day during the session of Parliament, where ministers have to respond to searching questions raised by the members. Second, zero hour, where members are free to raise any matter that they think is important for the public welfare. Third, adjourn motion. During adjournment motion, half an hour is for the discussion on matters of public importance. Adjournment motion, etc., is following such a type of questions which members of the house think they are important for the public welfare. Next instrument for the controlling of executive is approval or refusal of laws. No bill can become a law unless agreed to by both the houses. Week after week, the opposition scrutinizes minutely every legislative program for possible weaknesses and then mount attacks upon them. The opposition knows that the government will always win by making use of its majority in the Lok Sabha. But the sharp criticism in the Parliament finds wide publicity about failures of the government. The opposition, by talking in the House, is in fact talking to the country at large and is trying to make the ministers appear to the public eye either incompetent or corrupt, or if possible both. When the government is in the majority in the Lok Sabha but not in the Rajya Sabha, discord and division will be inevitable. Sometimes it creates clashes. Next, financial control. As mentioned earlier, financial resources to implement the programs of the government are granted through the budget. Preparation and presentation of budget for the approval of the legislature is constitutional obligation of the government. This obligation allows the legislature to exercise control over the purse strings of the government. Means when government present budget, then legislature get the chance to discuss that and regarding the all money matters related with countries. So the legislature may refuse to grant resources to the government which are proposed in the budget. This seldom happens because the government ordinarily enjoys support of the majority. Then, before granting money, the Lok Sabha can discuss the reasons for which the government requires money. And after that, Controller and Auditor General and Public Accounts Committees plays an important role, because all of you are well aware regarding the fact, basic work done by the our bureaucrats, and they prepared the report, they collect all the data, and then they present the report on the basis of data. So that is very much important in the house. No confidence motion. It is also a most important instrument in the hands of legislature. The most powerful weapon that enables the parliament to ensure executive accountability is the no confidence motion. As long as the government has the support of its party or coalition of parties that have a majority in the Lok Sabha, the power of the house to dismiss the government in fictional rather than real. However, for example, we can discuss the case in the year 1989. Several governments have been forced to resign due to lack of confidence of the house. Each of these governments lost the confidence of the Lok Sabha because they failed to retain the support of their coalition partners. In simple words, we can say, if ruling party don't get the confidence from the house, in that case they have to resign. That's why we can say all the ministers are sailing in the same boat. I hope all the points are clear to you. If you face any problem regarding any topic, you can ask during your live classes. Thank you and have a nice day.